Good afternoon, everyone. I am Beatrice Wassenberg, the president of the Birmingham Musicale, and the Lutheran Church of the Redeemer wishes to welcome you to their beautiful space here, and you feel free to check out all the other facilities here. And if you have any questions, they're in the office, like what services are coming up or any programs they're having here, and they'll be glad to help. The Birmingham Musicale is excited to have three of our award winners perform today. And our wonderful Birmingham Musicale Choral Ensemble under the direction of Joe Bentley. I know you're going to have a wonderful time and enjoy this performance. Now I'd like to hand this over to our chairman of the day, Mary Irvine.
Before I do anything else, I hope you have done it too, I'm going to quiet my phone. So would you all make sure your phones are muted, please? It's so nice to have you all here on this beautiful sunny spring day. We had such a wonderful week. We thought it's going to be perfect on Thursday, and then some of us had to swim to get here, right? So I know coming through some of the neighborhoods, it was really almost flooding in some places. And I just want to speak to you a little bit about the awards program that we have in the Birmingham Musicale. I'm chairman of the awards committee, and I'll introduce those wonderful people who serve in that committee in just a moment. I want you to know how hard they work. You know, many of you have known me for many years, and you know that I'm not the biggest fan of the National Federation of Music Clubs, which sounds very pompous. But the thing that I like about the National Federation of Music Clubs and the Michigan Federation of Music Clubs, and the reason I stick around, quote unquote, is because of the awards that are given. They're very interested in helping young musicians. And let's face it, if we want to have symphony orchestras, we have to have young musicians learning. If we want to have wonderful oratorios and operas performed, we have to have young musicians, singers. And notice I use the word musicians for singers. They have to be musicians. So we are part of that organization that gives awards itself, as well as the ones we give, of course, right up to the Young Artist Awards, which at that point they will help young artists begin their career with a recording contract, etc. So I think that's really worthwhile. And on our smaller level, we have, in our club, we sponsor 11 awards. Many of you may not know that. We have college age awards, high school age awards, a music therapy award, and one for financial assistance for piano lessons. So we try to cover a large span of opportunity for these young people. But that takes a lot of work. And one of the biggest jobs is making the publicity float out across the county and across the state what these awards are and how young people can apply for them. And that's where we use the benefit of the club members, having them distribute some of that publicity. But the chairman has to be the one who gets that already. They have to get the facility, they have to get the date. We have to make sure it doesn't clash with something that they're doing at school or with the MSBOA, which is the Band and Orchestra Association Festivals, or the MSVMA, which is the School's Vocal Music Association Festivals. And all of those have to be checked before any of those dates are booked. And then we get questions from people, why do you have it so late? Why do you have it so early? Well, we don't have much choice. We have to fit in where we can. So remember that when you're thinking about these people who do all this hard work. And I'd like to, if they're here, have each of them stand as I call out her name. We have Nina Flanagan, Priscilla Marino, Beatrice Wassenberg, Barbara Wolf, and then I'm the chairman. And Barb, stand up. Good. And thank you all so much for all the hard work you do. Now we get to the joy of the results of our hard work, and we get to listen to our at least three of our award winners today. And our first award winner, who's going to play for us, is Christopher Samuela, an alto saxophone. Christopher is 17 years old and in his junior year at Rochester High School. He's been playing alto saxophone for 6 years, during all of which time he has been studying with Emily Boris, who is a good friend to the Birmingham Musicale. He plays in the Detroit Symphony Youth Orchestra and has played in the Rochester High School Wind Ensemble for 3 years. Now remember, he's only 17 now. During that time, he has participated in the Michigan Schools Band and Orchestra Association solo and ensemble festivals every year and has received a superior Division I rating at both district and state levels. Christopher was very proud to be selected to perform in the honors bands for Wayne State University, Oakland University, and the Michigan Schools Band and Orchestra Association District 16 honors bands. In his free time, if he has any, Christopher enjoys participating in Romanian folklore as well as being involved in his church. So I'd like you now to give a warm welcome to Christopher Samuela.
Thank you.
And Christopher's wonderful piano accompanist was Emily Dudrich, as you can read on your program. And where would we be without wonderful pianists to accompany all the soloists? They make or break the soloists, but don't tell them that. Our next performer is the winner of the Junior Music Award Voice, and her name is Bella Hoover, soprano. She is 17 years old, and she began her voice training with Lauren Monaco when she was 12 years old. She is a junior at Stony Creek High School in Rochester and has been involved in the vocal music program there since she was a freshman. Currently, she sings in the high school chamber choir. Bella studied piano for about 5 years and also taught herself to play guitar. Also, she has been very involved with musical theater since she was 7 years old. She has participated in productions at All the World's a Stage, Rochester School's Summer Music Festival, Summer Music Theater, I should say, and Stony Creek High School. Some of her favorite roles include Mrs. Banks in Mary Poppins, Anastasia in Anastasia, and Eponine in Les Miserables, quite a range of characters. It is no surprise that Bella plans to pursue musical theater in college and beyond. In her free time, Bella loves to dance, play guitar and piano, and explore all kinds of music. And I know you're going to enjoy her wonderful program now, where she's accompanied by Colette Campura. Campura. Thank you.
Hooray!
For the accompanying. Too many notes. Our final award winner for this program is Spencer Sun. And Spencer is 16 years old and is in 10th grade at Stony Creek High School in Rochester Hills. And I would just like to point out, I don't know if it is registered with you, all three of our winners are from the Rochester schools. Two from Stony Creek and one from Rochester High School. Now, where's Birmingham and where's Bloomfield Hills? They don't apply. He has been studying piano with Catherine Rollins since he was 6 years old. Already, he has had much success in his piano competitions. In 2015 and 2017, he won awards in the Metropolitan Detroit Musicians League Young Artist competitions. In 2017 and 2023, he won first and second place awards, respectively, in the State Piano Concerto competitions. In 2021 and 2023, he won the Golden Key and the American Protégé International Piano Competitions. In 2023, he also won the second place award in the State Piano Competition of Michigan, and he won a special recognition award from the Birmingham Musicale. This year already, he has won first place in the 2024 Metropolitan Detroit Musicians League Young Artist Piano Competition. That's the one he won second place in before. And the first place award from the Birmingham Musicale. Spencer's other interests, I don't know where he gets the time, include playing on the varsity tennis team at his high school and singing tenor in his high school chamber choir. Also, he is dedicated to the first FIRST robotics team focusing on mechanical systems and maintenance in the pit crew. Amazing. Spencer's dream career would be working for NASA as an aerospace engineer or as an astronaut. But maybe he'll be playing piano in space, who knows? Let's welcome Spencer Sun.
Thank you.
Thank you, Spencer. Now we come to the second part of our program, which is featuring the Birmingham Musicale Choral Ensemble. We're very proud of the Birmingham Musicale Choral Ensemble because the club has had a choral ensemble since its inception. That's how it began, really. It began, as you can read, many, many years ago. 1926 was when it was formed. And it was formed by the ladies of that time, who I always think had too much spare time because they had lots of help. They didn't do all the housework, they didn't do all the dishwashing themselves, but also they didn't go to work because that was unheard of. So they had time free when the children were being cared for somewhere else or by someone else or at school, and they decided to get together a group to bring artists to the community of Birmingham to perform. And gradually their numbers grew and they began to want to perform themselves. So they started a choral ensemble. And from there to this, we are so fortunate to have this group with us today. And we are very fortunate to have Dr. Joe Bentley as our director. He is a joy as a musician and as a person, and certainly as a director. So please welcome the Birmingham Musicale Choral Ensemble. Thank you.
Yeah.